guys, I'm going to tell you what. This area, the roads are good. But once you get north of Coeur d'Alene High School, up into Hayden, it's an ice rink. And Josiah driving home, a lot of wrecks and different people too dangerous to drive. So this little cluster of North Idaho has been blessed by God because we could all make it to the house of the Lord. Amen. Amen. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for this service. Lord, that we can be in the house of God to worship you tonight. That's right. Come on, church. Let's give him honor and worship.
Majestic is your name. Lift up on high the name of Jesus.
God's house with God's people worshiping the Lord in spirit and truth. Thank you, Sister Natalie, and praise God. I've asked Brother Lukky to minister the word tonight, and it's his birthday today. So happy birthday, Brother Lukky. Praise God, and we appreciate you and thank God for you, our assistant pastor here. So come on and preach to us the word in the name of Jesus. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Amen.
Well, praise the Lord, everyone. Come on, let's worship him tonight. Let's praise the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. He's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. I know we're tired tonight. Hallelujah. I know that there's not many here, but he is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Let's lift our voice. Hallelujah. Let's shout with the voice of triumph. Hallelujah. We serve a great and mighty God. Hallelujah, who can do exceedingly above anything we can ask or think. Hallelujah. Oh, glory. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You guys may be seated tonight. You know, there's days like this that I'm so thankful that my job is indoors. And I'm so thankful that I'm not working outside in the cold. And I'll tell you what, once I get out to that car, or get out to go in the car, I'm like, I'm just ready for some heat. So I thank God for some Holy Ghost heat in here tonight. And hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I just want to tell this church thank you for loving me and my family. You guys have blessed my family. And I just appreciate this church and the love and the support that you guys give us. Yeah, this is home. I'm like, I thank God that I could come here and I could feel the presence of God and be amongst brothers and sisters in Christ and worship with you guys. And there's nothing like it. And I'm so thankful for it and so appreciative of each and every one of you. Hallelujah. And if you would turn with me tonight to 1 Kings chapter 17, and we'll read from 12 down to 16. I was going to preach tonight. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. But I looked around and I said, maybe that's not the message tonight. Maybe there's for a different time. Maybe that's a Sunday type of message. But God's so good. He's so good. Hallelujah. When you're there, say amen. Hallelujah. So 1 Kings 17, starting at verse 12. And he said, actually, you know what, let me read from 8 to 16. I would like to start there, but I want to build some context in here as well. And it goes to say, and the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, arise, get thee to Zarephath, which belongeth to Zidon, and dwell there. Behold, I have commanded it a widow woman there to sustain thee. So he arose and went to Zarephath, and when he came to the gate of the city, behold, the widow woman was there gathering of sticks. And he called to her and said, fetch me, I pray thee, a little water in a vessel, that I may drink. And as she was going to fetch it, he called to her and said, "Bring me, I pray thee, a morsel of bread in thy hand." And she said, "As the Lord thy God liveth, I have not a cake, but a handful of meal in a barrel, and a little oil in a cruse. And behold, I am gathering two sticks that I may go in and dress it for me and my son, that we may eat it and die." And Elijah said unto her, "Fear not, go and do as thou hast said, but make me thereof a little cake first, and bring it on to me, and after make for thee and for thy son, for this saith the Lord God of Israel, the barrel of meal shall not waste, neither shall the cruse of oil fail, until that day the Lord sendeth rain upon the earth." And she went and did according to the saying of Elijah, and she and he and her house did eat many days. And the barrel of meal wasted not, neither did the cruse of oil fail, according to the word of the Lord, which he spake by Elijah. Hallelujah. God is faithful. Hallelujah. I want to preach to you tonight. The need is greater than the supply. Jesus, Lord God, we love you tonight. God, we give you all the honor and all the praise and all the glory, God. I thank you for the truth of your word. I thank you, Lord God, for being with us here tonight, God. There is no greater place on earth to be, God, than in your presence, God. I pray for your peace, God. I pray you would meet every need in your house, God. I pray, God, that the power of the Holy Ghost would flow, God. And Jesus, do exactly what you intend to do here tonight, God. Perform your word with signs following, I pray in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And the church said amen. The need is greater than the supply. This woman, she had a need. The man of God had a need as well. He was answering the call of God, and he was following what God had told him to do. And God told him, "Hey, you know what? You're going to go find a widow woman. Out of all the things in that was possible, you're going to go find a woman. Where that's where your help's going to come from. That's where your help's going to originate from." And I don't know what Elijah was thinking, but I think he's been through enough things to know that, hey, God, I don't understand it all, and I don't need to understand it all, but I'm going to listen and I'm going to obey. Sometimes you don't have to understand every little detail that God is trying to do. You don't have to try to figure it out. You don't have to try to figure out what God is doing. You just got to trust him and obey. You just got to follow where he's bringing you. You just got to walk in where he's calling you. Sometimes we just don't want to, we want to figure God out. We want to say, "Hey, God, I'll take that step, but you tell me what you're doing." Well, God told Elijah what he was doing. He said, "Go find a widow woman. Let's start there first." God will give you a starting point. He won't give you an end date. He'll give you a start date. Once you start walking, then he'll start letting you know how it's all going to unfold. It takes faith to live for God. It takes faith to walk in the presence of God. It takes faith to live for God on your job when nobody else wants to hear it. It takes faith to live for God when your spouse doesn't want to live for God. Bible commands us to love God with everything that we are, all of our being. That's leaving nothing out. That's not even leaving a tiny little morsel out. That's everything. And as hard as that may seem, he's worthy of it. As hard as it may seem to get up in each morning and pray, we got to get up and pray. Sometimes you just crucify this flesh and tell this flesh what it needs to do. Sometimes you don't want to come to the house of God, but you show up to the house of God. And when you get here, give him everything you got. I know our bodies get tired and they get weary. But don't go weary in well-doing. The need is greater than the supply. This woman had a need. This woman was a widow. She was without a husband. and she had a child to care for. Just put yourself in her shoes. And she was desperate. And she was so desperate that God said, hey, you know what? I'm going to bring you a man of God because you need a miracle. And you don't know where your miracle is coming from. You think you're just feeding a prophet of the Lord. You just think you're just doing what the Lord God, the man of God is asking you to do. But there's a miracle behind it. We could easily look at our supply and say, I got nothing. I got nothing to give. I got nothing. I got no oil. I got no more meal. I got nothing left. We could be in seasons of life where we can look at our supply and say, I got nothing. The barely what I got, I'm going to hold on to. It's very easy to hold on to what we got when you don't got nothing. And it's very easy to hold on to when you got a lot as well. We could go to the rich young ruler. The rich young ruler didn't want to give up what he had. He was focused on the supply. He was focused on what he had instead of the need that he had. We can so focus on our supply and our own abilities that we miss out on God. We miss out on what God has for us. I thank God for what I have, but my faith and trust is not in those things. I thank God for everything that he has blessed me with. I thank God that everything he has given me, but if I had to go through a Job moment and I had to go through a season where everything was stripped, I pray in Jesus' name that I say, hey, the Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. This woman was stripped of everything. This woman, everything was taken from her. And the audacity of Elijah to ask her of anything. Sometimes we can get a little pity party and God, why are you asking me to do this? Do you know what I have? Have you seen my supply? Have you seen what I have? Have you seen everything that I've given you? And it's cost me everything. It's cost me friendships. It's cost me dear relationships. It's cost me my money. It's cost me everything. I don't know if you look at my refrigerator, there's nothing in it. And on the counter, there's some oil and there's some flour. That's all I got. I got enough to make a few cakes and that's it. And I'm going to go and die. What a miserable moment in this woman's life. It's desperation. She's given up. She's throwing in the towel. This woman needed a miracle. She had a need that was greater than her supply. She had a need that she was, I need something. But guess what? If that need doesn't come, it's over. It's all she wrote. It's all over. I thank God that our relationship with God is not based on our supply. Most of us, before we came to God, our supply was rather empty. We might be living in blessing right now when our cup might be overflowing, but that's not always the season we're living in. That's not always the season we're in. I remember I heard that on Mount Everest, you only could stay on top about 12 minutes. Eventually, you got to come off the mountaintop. The supplies that got you there have ran out. The need is greater than the supply. Our needs are met by God. And our greatest needs that we have are spiritual ones. They're not physical in nature. And God's saying, hey, you know what? I got a miracle. I got a supernatural miracle waiting for you. This woman didn't know what was coming her way. And child of God, I just want to encourage you tonight. Hold on. I know the supplies look low. I know when you look around, you're wondering, where is it going to come? Where is my miracle going to show up? But just hold on, child of God. Your miracle's on the way. Hallelujah. Let's magnify the Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus. I couldn't fathom this situation. I got kids. I couldn't fathom watching them and having their last meal and saying, hey, this is it. This is it. Looking at my child and saying, she probably made it as comfortable for him as she possibly could. She probably didn't even tell him how much supply she had. She knew she was running low. She knew she was running empty. Child of God, this is the place to come to when you're running empty. This is the place that you need to come to when you're running empty and running low. Don't get so desperate and so such in a hurry that you cause to do something foolish and something that's going to cost you to lose it all. It's very easy to hold on to the supply, because when it's all that you got, you're holding on to it as tight. But this woman, she was willing. Say, she was willing. Child of God, you got to be willing to give God everything that you got and know that he's going to meet the needs that you have in your life. You have needs tonight. We all have needs. Are we trusting God with those needs? Are we giving those needs to God? Or do we look at our supply and say, I got enough to carry me through? The five foolish virgins thought they had enough supply. Don't trust your supply. Don't trust what you have built up and stored up. When manna rained down from heaven, he said, hey, you gotta eat it today, and tomorrow it's gonna spoil. Church, we got a need each and every day that needs to be met, and it's not a physical need, it is a spiritual need. We need the gift of the Holy Ghost. We need to be walking in the Spirit. We need to be operating in the Holy Ghost. I need a walk with God. You need to wake up and say, I need it. I know what I got yesterday. I know my supply, but I can't base my walk with God on the supply that I have. You know, the amazing thing about the five wise virgins and the five foolish virgins, God never told those five wise virgins how much oil they were supposed to have. We see in this scripture that this woman's supply doesn't run out until the rain comes, until the harvest comes, because rain means harvest. Rain means blessing. God sustained her all the way until that harvest came. Child of God, hold on. The harvest is coming. Church, hold on. The harvest is coming. I look about. I don't know if you guys have seen the Asbury revival they're calling. And I'm looking at that, and I'm thinking, I'm like, the harvest is white and ready to be harvested. They're hungry. They might not have the truth, but there's hunger. When you look out and about, you got to realize, hey, that they are seeking a need. They ran out supply. The world didn't give them what they wanted to have. They realized, hey, that supply is running empty. It's running low. It's not doing what I want it to. I got a need, and it's bigger than what I have in my supply cabinet. Philippians 4:19, but my God, say my God, it's your God. He shall supply all your needs. Say all my needs. He's willing to meet all your needs tonight, according to his riches in glory and by Christ Jesus. He's willing to meet your need tonight. I don't know what your need tonight is, child of God, but he's able to meet it. Stop looking at your supply. Stop looking at what you have and start looking at what you need. And what you need is, hallelujah, more of the Holy Ghost. What you need of more, hallelujah, of a walk with God. Matthew 6:8 says, for your Father knoweth what things you have need of
before you ask him. He already knows the need. He already knew this woman's need, that this woman had a need in her life. And she's like, hey, you know what? God's saying, hey, I got a man of God that has a need in it as well. He's coming in. He's hungry. He's journeyed. When somebody's willing to bless you, don't reject that blessing, because that could be that person's miracle. There's times in life that I looked at the person and said, they don't have very much. I can't take anything from them. Don't rob somebody of their miracle. If God has put it on their heart to give, let them give. Let them be your miracle and God will be their miracle. Get your eyes of what you lack in your supply cabinet. We all lack something. I remember when Peter and James come on to the lame guy at the gate called Beautiful. And this man had a little change jar. And he was shaking and he couldn't do it. And Peter said, hey, look on me. And what I do have, I don't have what you're asking. My supply is ran low, but I have a need. Hallelujah. I have a God that's able to raise you up. You're looking at your supply and thinking that's going to keep you. But what you need is a miracle. What you need is something to sustain you throughout your life, to get you to the blessing, to get you to the provision, to get you to the answer that you need. He was a lame man at the gate called Beautiful. He was looking at his supply, and he wanted, and Peter said, look on me. Sometimes you got to just pick up your eyes and look to Jesus and say, God, I'm tired of trusting in the supplies that I have. I have a need, God, and you're able to meet it. Silver and gold have I none. You know, sometimes when you leave the supply, Peter left his supply back. He said, silver and gold have I none. Hey, I laid it all down. I gave it all up. Because Jesus met every one of my needs. He saved me. He delivered me. He made me whole. Hallelujah. Hey, my supply doesn't run empty anymore. Hallelujah. I'm so filled with the power and the Spirit of God that it's sustaining me. It's carrying me. It's driving me. What this woman needed was a miracle. Her supply was only going to get her so far. Your supplies and the things that you hold on to this life are only going to get you so far. They're only going to bring you just another day and another day and another day. But God's able to sustain you through your whole entire life, through your trials, through your tribulations, through your fears, through your doubt. He's able to sustain you. He's able to meet your needs in every season that you are in. That's what makes God so great, is we're all have different needs in the house tonight. We all have different things that we need God to work in. We need a miracle. And God sees your needs tonight just like he saw this widow woman's need. God gave me a word to give to you that he is able to meet that need tonight. But you need to stop looking at your supply and stop trusting in your supply, and just trust in the one that's able to meet your needs tonight. Our greatest need is salvation. I can't make it without being saved. I can't make it with just living life carelessly and foolishly. I need to be saved. And not only do I need to be born again, but I need to stay saved. Because I have a God that's able to supply all my needs according to his riches and glory. I want you to bring your supply to God and say, God, I don't need it anymore. God, I'm giving it to you. God, I'm trusting you with everything that I got. I'm giving you my all. I'm giving you everything that I have, because I know you're able to do more with it than I could ever do. much, but all he's asking is for what you got. You may say, I might have just two little mites, but God said, that's enough. That's enough. You don't have to have the whole world. You don't have to have lots of money. What you need is just, you need have to bring your supply to God and say, God, do with it what you will. Because I only could get so far with it, but you can churn 5 loaves and 2 fishes, hallelujah, and you could feed the 5,000. Why? Because the need is greater than the supply. You will have no problem with giving up your supply when you realize that your need is greater and who you're giving it up to. God can take that need and make a miracle out of it. This woman needed a miracle. This woman was willing to give up everything that she had. She was willing to give up her supply for a miracle. And the barrel of meal wasted not, neither did the curse of oil fail according to the word of the Lord. If God said it, it's already done. I love this church building. I was saved here. I remember was filled with the Holy Ghost just right down in that walkway. And I thank God for what he's done for me in this place. But guess what? This place, Mike, he supplied everything that we need, but this place is not the final place. God has something bigger and God has something better for us. He supplied our every need in this place. But God says, I got something better for you. I believe that there is a need tonight. We need a bigger building. I look around and when this place is full and on a Sunday, I look around and I say, God, there is a need here. You can take our supplies and what we can give and you can do something with it. If you give him everything that you got and give him everything that you have, whether it's a lot or a little, God is able to do exceedingly above anything we could ask or think. In John chapter 2, we read about the first miracle. I want to point something out. This is the first miracle where Jesus turns water into wine. And it says, in the third day, there was a marriage in Cana of Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there, and both Jesus was called and his disciples to the marriage. Verse 3, and when they wanted wine, the mother of Jesus saith unto them, they have no wine. Their supplies are empty. They're low. They got no more wine. This party is going to stop here. Jesus saith unto her, woman, what have I to do with thee? Mine hour is not yet come. There was a need that needed to be met. Then the supplies were running empty. And his mother saith unto the servants, whatsoever he saith unto you, do it. Whatever God is asking you to do tonight, whatever God is asking you to give up, whatever God is asking you to bring towards to him, just do it. And God's able to do something with it. God's able to meet your needs. The need is greater than the supply. If you would stand here tonight, if Sister Natalie would come to the keyboard. Do whatever he asks you. Just like Elijah. This woman did everything that he had asked her to do. He needed water. He brought him water. He needed him to be made a cake. with some oil. She brought a cake. She brought her supplies. Why? Because her need was greater than the supply. Whatever you do, do it on to the Lord. God is able to take a couple fishes and a couple loaves and meet a need of a hungry people. Don't look at the supply and say, hey, I don't got much. That's all God needs. It's all God needs tonight. It's just what you have. It might not be much, but if you bring it to the Lord, He's able to meet those needs. But He's asking for faith. He's asking for us to walk in faith, to trust Him with the little things. The rich young ruler, he focused on his supply. He focused on what he did have. Lot's wife, she was a little salty. She looked back and she focused on what she was losing. She looked back and looked at her supply, not realizing God was working a miracle out for her. God was saving her from where she's at. Church, we can get so complacent and look at our supply and trust in it and lose out on with God. For what shall it profit a man if he gains the whole world or loses his soul? You could gain the whole world. You could have as much substance, as much supply as you want. But what is going to profit you if you lose out on your own soul? If you lose out with God? If you lose out with your walk with God? Hallelujah. I invite you to come here tonight. I thank you for you guys attendiveness and you guys showing up here tonight. And I invite you to come here tonight and I invite you to bring your supplies, whatever you have.